morning, everyone. It is bright and early on Sunday morning, and we are here at EPCOT. It's also the Food and Wine Festival, which I've never been to before, and tomorrow's the last day, so I knew I had to come today. So we are gonna try some good food. We're gonna meet Elsa and Anna, maybe do Frozen Ever After if the line isn't too bad. And first we're gonna find a bathroom because I haven't gone to the bathroom since I left my apartment an hour ago. And I gotta go. Okay, so I made a spur of the decision moment to get in line to meet Baymax. So we are about to meet Baymax. So I just got through meeting Baymax, and I honestly just like grinned like an idiot the whole time because he was so cute and precious, and big hugs. And now I am across the hall to meet Joy and Sadness, and their little room is so adorable. They've got memories all over the walls. It's so cute. Okay, so I just met Joy and Sadness, and it was so cute, and oh my god, I was like on the verge of tears the whole time. And now I am over here at the Festival Center for the Food and Wine Festival, and annual pass holders get a pin. I don't know if we like have to buy it or if it's like just available for pass holders or how it works, so we're gonna go in here and check things out and see what it's like. So these are our buttons that we get for being a pass holder, and super cute. It has Remy. I almost called him Ratatouille, but I knew that wasn't his name. It's got Remy on it, and it's super cute, and I'm excited. Also, this is the inside. This used to be like the body pavilion. They had this ride called Body Wars that was really gross and disgusting, and it was like you were inside the human body. I think you were like some kind of like red blood cell or something, but it's really cool that they actually still use this for something since that pavilion is actually closed down. Okay, so I love Figment, and they have so much Figment stuff here, and it's so amazing. They have a little chef hat that's an apron. It's so cute. They even have a little stuffed Figment in a little chef outfit. So cute. So I went ahead and bought this little tray. It's to carry around your food and stuff that you try around the world. And I'm excited. It even says 2017 on it. So that was definitely a contributing factor in buying it. And I got a discount on it. So it was only $4.25. How amazing is that? I love being an AP. Oh yeah. Time to vomit after drinking Beverly. You have to like mentally prepare yourself to drink Beverly because it's just so disgusting. I can't do this. Oh my god, I'm nervous. Okay, so I do this every time because I never know if I have new viewers on my channel. But this is Beverly. It stinks. It's notoriously disregarded here in the Disney fandom because it tastes terrible. And I always do a reaction video of me trying it, so bottoms up. I'm not drinking this whole thing, but bottoms up. It never gets any better. And it like leaves your like whole entire mouth numb. It's disgusting, and I hate it with my entire being. So these are all the different flavors. That's Beverly. It's terrible. All the other ones are actually pretty good. This one tastes like water, so it's kind of gross. But everything else is pretty decent, and I would recommend all of them, except for you. Okay, first food of the day from Food & Wine. This is loaded mac and cheese. It's from Active Eats here in Future World. And I'm excited. It looks really good. Okay, so I'm eating this mac and cheese, and it's actually pretty spicy. I think it has the macaroni. It's got some bacon. It looks like there's some green onions in here and some kind of peppers in here as well. And it's actually, it's pretty good. I'm not that big on vegetables, and so the fact that I'm actually eating the vegetables in this is actually something to be noted.
That's what I tried right there, the mac and cheese.
It was really nice.
I got the liquid nitro chocolate on the truffle, and I'm excited.
Okay, so here it is. It looks amazing. I can't wait to try it.
Okay, so I'm eating this, and the caramel has whiskey in it, and you can actually like really taste it. I'm not much of a whiskey person. This is really good. It's like, I don't know why I didn't make the connection between nitro and cold. This is like ice cream kind of, but it's really good.
Okay, so I'm here at Norway and I am about to get in line to go visit the Royal Sommerhus to meet Elsa and Anna.
A reference to Maelstrom and the troll in that ride. I miss it.
Okay, so I just met Elsa and Anna, and it was honestly, I'm always super awkward when I meet Elsa and Anna because I just get so starstruck because they're my favorite, and I'm just kind of like, nice to meet you. And so it's really funny, but I don't know if I want to do Frozen Ever After. I just checked it and it had like an hour and a half wait, so let me check my phone and see how bad it is. I think I'm gonna risk doing Frozen Ever After because it was 85 and now it's down to like 75. And the line also isn't all the way back out here like it was when we were here in December. So I think I'm gonna go for it. Guess who's in the front row? It's me. I'm in the front row all by myself. I'm gonna get wet. This is my favorite part. That's a lie, but I love this. All this water in my pants. They've already got stuff out for the, Olaf's Frozen Adventure, that's what it's called. Wow, I'm a bad Frozen fan, but they've got Elsa here and Anna right over there. So cute. I cannot wait for the short. They've got some artwork over here. This one right here. They've got 5 different ones. I really want that one because I love Elsa, and also that one because I love Elsa.
What else do they have around here? Ooh, a snow globe. That's cute. It's got Olaf in it. A scary looking Olaf. Oh, this is for Olaf's Frozen Adventure. That's why it's scary. I wish they had like adult shirts with marshmallow on it because I love marshmallow very much. I have him at home. It's been a while since I've seen him. I packed him away. What else over here? Oh, that's all like Norway stuff. This is all Norway stuff too. So this guy has been here forever. And he used to scare me when I was a kid. And he really made me nervous. So that took a little bit longer, I think, than I anticipated. And originally I was gonna leave EPCOT at 3:30. But I think I've decided that if I leave at 4:30, that still gives me an hour and a half to take the boat over to the park, to Hollywood Studios, and get over to the Frozen Sing-Along, which is literally like right there on the main street going down Hollywood Studios. So I think I'm gonna hang around here for, I think it's like 3:30 now, so I'll have another hour to walk around and try some more food, and then I will head over to Hollywood Studios. So we're gonna see what different kind of foods they have around the actual World Showcase part of EPCOT. Okay, so I'm here at the India booth and I'm going to try the pistachio cardamom bundt cake. So hopefully it tastes good. Okay, here it is, the pistachio cardamom bundt cake. It's got chocolate coconut mousse on the top. So let me just... Okay. I actually don't know that I'm a fan of pistachio, but I guess we're gonna find out a little bit. It has a little bit of a tang to it that I wasn't expecting, but it's good. I like it. It's very sweet. Okay, I'm stopping just a little bit of a way down in Africa, and I'm going to try the spinach and paneer cheese pocket because I like cheese and I like spinach. Okay, so here is the spinach and paneer cheese pocket. It's got some kind of mint garnish on the top. And I'm not sure what it's gonna taste like. Okay, so the spinach and paneer pocket is actually, it's pretty good. It's spicy. It's a lot spicier than I thought it would be. So I'm not a fan of the mint garnish on the top. It's kind of sour, so I kind of scraped it off the top. But this is really good. It was really spicy, and I love spicy food. I know I'm making a face, but it's spicy, and I really like it. Okay, I have stopped in Italy, and I'm getting cannoli al cioccolato. Actually, I got it already, and here it is right here. Okay, it looks like there's some kind of fruit maybe inside of the cannoli. So here we go. Oh, there's a cookie inside. Which I guess makes sense because it is cannoli. It's good. It kind of tastes a lot like the pistachio thing I just ate, so. But I couldn't say no to chocolate. Alright, I'm in Belgium and I got the Belgian waffle with warm chocolate ganache and whipped cream. I would do a video of me eating the Belgian waffle, but I've actually I've actually got to head to the boat to get over to Hollywood Studios here pretty quick, so I'm gonna kind of walk and eat at the same time. It's getting windy out here, but I just got off. Sorry, my mom texted me about Disney and I was like, why? I just got off the boat. I was actually able to get on like immediately, and it was like a 25-minute boat ride over here. And I'm here at Hollywood Studios. It's all Christmassy here too. And I think I'm gonna go try and meet Olaf. He's only got like a 20-minute wait right now. So I've gotta get through the bag check and I'm gonna go for it. About to meet Olaf. It's only 10 minutes. So I just met Olaf and he was super duper cute. He got all bashful and shy and he like
drew a heart with his fingers, and it was super cute. And I just remembered that you can meet BB-8 now here at Hollywood Studios, and it's only like a 20 minute wait, so I'm going to like go do that and then like literally run back over to my fast pass for Elsa and Anna, or the sing along, at 6 to 6:15. Wish me luck. Oh no, BB-8's moved up to 25. Who else? Ooh, Kylo Ren's only 15. What do you think? Should I do Kylo Ren instead? Do you think I should do Kylo Ren instead? And then I could come back afterwards and meet BB-8 when I have more time after my fast pass for Frozen. I'm gonna do Kylo Ren. Wish me luck. I'm so nervous. I've met Kylo Ren before and I'm still scared. He frightens me. Okay, I survived, but like barely. He led me over to the like photo spot, and he's like, "I've heard the droid is with the rebel cause. Do you have any knowledge on that?" And I was like, "No." And he was like, "How noble! You'll go down in history as a hero." And I was just like, "Okay." And then we took pictures, and like the whole time I'm like side-eyeing him super hard. I was like, "Whew." Oh, buddy, I was a mess. But let's see. It's, oh, perfect. It's 5:55. And so my fast pass for Frozen is at 6. So that was like perfect timing. And then once this is done, I'll have like an hour. So I'm going to go over to meet BB-8, hopefully. And then it's Fantasmic at 7:50.
Talking about Han was in there, or maybe not. I saw Han. He disappeared. How rude. I hope they're gonna talk about Han.
This is like when they shuffle everybody in, and like everyone literally like pushes to the front. Okay, people need to decide where they want to go. Oh, that was a really awkward way to turn around the camera. But I have heard that there's a holiday tag at the end of this now, which has music from the Olaf's Frozen Adventure short. So that'll be exciting. We're gonna be right here where Elsa comes out, right there. That's gonna be exciting. Anyways, there's supposed to be a holiday tag with music from the Olaf's Frozen Adventure short now, so I'm excited about that. It's gonna be really fun. Oh, I didn't even see that. It's all decorated for Christmas. It's got little Christmas wreaths, and it's really cute. I'm excited.
Build a snowman. Come on, let's go and play.
I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies, and now we're not. I wish you would tell me why. Do you want to build a snowman? It doesn't have to be a snowman.
Oh, wait, Anna.
Okay, bye.
For BB-8, it's like 15 minutes, and then I'm gonna get some Starbucks, and then I'm gonna head to Fantasmic. I can't take any pictures because my camera memory card is full, which is why I'm taking videos on my phone again, but it's gonna be a good night.
So I went in to Starbucks to buy my coffee. It's not coffee, it's a frappuccino, and I ordered, and you know, oh my goodness, there's stuff, things, but let me duck in here real quick, since I was in the middle of saying something. So I go to get my, I go up there to get my drink, and you know, she saw that it was my birthday, and she's like, happy birthday. And so she took my drink order, and she said, this one's on Mickey today, so you're all set. So I just got a venti frappuccino for free, and apparently now there is stuff going on. Movie magic, I think they said, Disney movie magic. So we're gonna watch this for a little bit because I still have like 20 minutes before Fantasmic. It's snowing. Every time I go to film, loud music happens, but it's snowing. There's snow everywhere. It's all over the place. It's crazy. So much snow. The tower looks disgusting, but it actually looks pretty cool. Like, you have to see it in person, and up close it looks a lot better than it did way back at the Chinese theater. I'm going to Fantasmic with my whole entire party. I was going to try and wait for them to stop doing announcements, but they're doing it in a lot of different languages, but I'm here for
fantastic. I am turning around right by the front, which is pretty good considering I took forever to actually sit down and get a seat. And I've got my Starbucks drink and I've got popcorn and I'm ready. And since I'm on my phone and can't zoom in to take decent pictures, and since I can't take decent videos with it either, I think I'm going to draw a line for the vlog tonight. Also, I just really want to enjoy Fantasmic since it is my birthday and it's my favorite show. So, if you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, ideas for videos, leave them down below in the comments. Thank you guys for hanging out with me for my birthday weekend.